Hey there, Bruni here, and today I've got a very interesting question. What if we did not feel pain? What would be the consequences of not being able to feel pain or sense when something is wrong with your body? The answer to this question is actually very interesting. But first off, we need to establish a few things: the meaning of pain and how we actually feel pain. According to the Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary, pain is a basic bodily sensation induced by a noxious stimulus. If you don't understand what the term noxious stimulus means, it's basically anything that is capable of causing harm to our body. Outside stimuli such as pins, knives, getting hit by something, or inside stimuli such as swallowing something dangerous or bleeding internally can cause you to feel pain. In fact, here's how the whole process of pain works. Our nervous systems are made up of two main parts, the brain and the spinal cord. These two combine to form the central nervous system and the sensory and motor nerves, which form the peripheral nervous system. It can be easily thought of as this: the brain and spinal cord are the hubs, while the sensory and motor nerves stretch out to provide access to all other areas of our body. The sensory nerves send impulses about what is happening to our environment to the brain via the spinal cord. The brain sends information back to our motor nerves, which help us perform actions. Okay, so how do our nerves know what can hurt us and what can't? Well, different sensory nerve fibers respond to different things and produce different chemical responses, which determine how sensations are interpreted. Some nerves send signals associated with light touch, while others respond to deep pressure. Special pain receptors called nociceptors activate when there has been an injury or even potential injury, such as breaking the skin or causing a large indentation in our body. Depending on the scale of the situation, our bodies react differently. Even if an object does not pierce through our skin, it may compress a part of your body, causing a signal to be sent from your nociceptors all the way up your spine and to your brain. This process actually happens within a fraction of a second, and there is almost instant response. When I was doing my research on this topic, it actually crossed my mind that there may be a disorder which may cause someone to not feel pain, and I actually confirmed that. It's called congenital analgesia. It's a disorder that prevents people from sensing pain and usually starts very early during childhood. It can be caused by an increased production of endorphins in the brain. Basically, it is an increase in a group of hormones secreted within the brain and nervous system and having a number of physiological functions. They are peptides that activate the body's opiate receptors, causing an analgesic effect. This makes someone feel relaxed or energetic, and while they may sound amazing since they prevent us from feeling pain, there is actually a really huge downside to this. Let's say that you get cut badly, but these endorphins prevent your brain from realizing that you have an issue. You may end up losing a lot of blood and not even be able to be aware of when you got hurt. You see, the downside of not being able to feel pain is that we may not be aware of current and potential dangers to our body and our health. You may get broken bones, cuts, wounds, and probably not even notice it unless someone inspects your body to make sure that everything is fine. While it may seem simple, the process of detecting pain is actually very complicated by the fact that it's not a one-way system. It isn't even a two-way system. Pain is more than just cause and effect. It is affected by everything else that is going on in the nervous system. Your mood, your past experiences, your expectations, they can all change the way pain is interpreted at any given time. Pain is our body's reaction to external stimuli, and currently it plays a major role in helping us notice if something is wrong and come up with a solution to that problem. Our genetic makeup is amazing, and the one who created us is a mastermind. So if you ever hear someone saying that they wish they did not feel any sort of pain, tell them they're asking for a whole lot of trouble. Guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, smash that like button down below. If you want more, subscribe and comment below what you think about this video. Until next time, this has been Bruni, and I will be seeing you in the next one.